Welcome to the Joe Cohen Show. Join me as I share my experience with biohacking and invite top health experts to explore the latest technology, supplements, research, and resources for optimizing your body and brain.
Today, I want to talk about the probiotic Longum. So I'm talking about some probiotics because this is something that I'm interested in lately. And this is something that's in my action plan for a while now. So it's Bifidobacterium Longum. And this is, I would say, probably my top three favorite probiotics. This is most reliably the thing that gets rid of gas, like better than anything else. There's one other one that works pretty well, but this is, I'd say, probably the number one thing. And so let's look at how this thing, I just searched for this. It comes up as 332 priority of this recommendation for your overall health. And let's see how it interacts with me and then how it, some of the other benefits that it has as well. So flatulence, I definitely noticed. These are symptoms and conditions that I've put into self-decode. These are my goals. These are DNA risks, lab risks, and lifestyle risks. Flatulence, definitely notice an effect. Let's look at the clinical trials for this. So some meta-analysis of 10 studies. There's also a lot of studies on it. Found that probiotics improve pain scores in people with IBS. They contain Longum. All probiotics DCs tested improve flatulence. But this one was particularly studied with the meta-analysis. It helps regulate, it aids in the digestion of complex carbohydrates. Regular ingestion can reduce bloating and abdominal pain. So definitely helps with flatulence, gut inflammation, food allergies as well, I would say. This is more like probably because it's one of the things I've done and food allergies went down. So I did many things, but it's one of the things I did. And so I think it helps. Let's see. What's the evidence? It's one of the key, one of its key mechanisms is the production of I3A, interesting, metabolite derived from tryptophan. So it can activate the aryl hydrocarbon receptor, which plays a crucial role modulating immune response and maintaining intestinal barrier function integrity. So this is actually something that's very important. I didn't even realize this until now. It helps promote regulatory T cell function, increases the production of protective mucosal barriers in the gut. Furthermore, Longum supports the balanced gut microbiome, which is vital for a healthy immune system. So when you consume tryptophan, it produces these metabolites, and some of these metabolites help produce what's called oral tolerance. It helps your gut tolerate proteins, and then you're not allergic to them. So I used to be allergic to almost every food, and now I'm not allergic to almost any food. And I think part of that was the probiotic combined with tryptophan, combined with a whole bunch of other things. I've spoken about it before. But I wouldn't be surprised if this one helped a lot as well, because taking this also, I think, reduced my food sensitivities. Goals, cognitive function, I wouldn't be surprised if it did. Let's see what the studies there on cognitive function. Study investigating on cognitive function, 60 healthy older adults with cognitive impairment. So it improved immediate memory, visuospatial, constructional attention, delayed memory domains. I wouldn't be surprised. Look, there's some things. I wouldn't say that this is something strong that I've noticed, but focus. Well, one of the things was attention. So that's why it's coming up as focus as well. Yeah, so attention, memory, short-term memory. So this is, these are the things that it helps with: cognitive function, focus, memory, short-term memory. I wouldn't be surprised if it helped. It's not something I paid attention when I did mega dosing experiments, but we'll look at my notes just so I get a refresher. It could be something that I noticed and I just forgot about it. But the thing that I noticed the most was flatulence, so like gas, food allergies. Again, hard to pinpoint sometimes because when you do 15 different things for food allergies and the food allergies go away, you can't always be certain. I would say like, probably 10 of those things I could definitely pinpoint, like, yeah, this helped. This is one of the things that probably helped, but I can't be sure. Let's look at some of the DNA risks that it's helping with. Flu, food allergies. Okay. And by the way, I have a risk for food allergies too. IBS, flatulence, go figure. Hay fever, I don't have, but my mom has it. So makes sense. Short-term memory impairment, I could see that. And I had brain fog. Homocysteine, definitely always have high homocysteine unless I do something. So interesting enough, this lowers homocysteine. It reduces homocysteine in people with kidney failure. Okay. It may reduce homocysteine in elderly people, but this is a mixture of probiotics. Okay. So it reduces homocysteine. But let's look at some of the other things. Labrys, hsCRP, this is usually not high, but it was high the last time. Phosphorus can be not optimal some of the times. These are things that were not optimal in the past, but are optimal now. So this reduces phosphorus. It may reduce levels by fermenting carbohydrates and producing short-chain fatty acids, resulting in decrease in intestinal pH and phosphate ionization. So this is something that I do try to get down. And the reason, by the way, that my phosphorus is higher is because I eat a lot of animal protein. So the more protein you eat, protein comes with phosphorus. And so it's just natural that the phosphorus, and by the way, it's not like it's high, it's just not optimal. So you see, it's out of optimal. This sign means it's out of optimal. Doesn't mean that it's actually high. And let's look at the lifestyle risk. ADHD, definitely had that before. Food allergies, hay fever. Just helping with these. Okay. Now I have an understanding of how it's helping with my risk. Let's see how it helps in general with stuff. Respiratory infections. I like things that help with that because I used to get sick a lot. Ulcerative colitis, anxiety, fatty liver, insulin resistance, allergies, attention, constipation. So these are things I don't have genetic risk for, but it helps with anyway. Cognitive function, histamine intolerance. I don't have that. Memory performance, TNF, lactose intolerance. So here we see all the benefits of B. longum. Side effects, gastrointestinal discomfort, allergic reactions, uncommon. Bad interactions, antibiotics, immunosuppressant may increase the risk of infections because the product can affect the immune system's balance, which may be problematic for immune compromised individuals. So it's traditionally improved, used for gut health, enhanced digestion, support immune function, alleviate IBS. I would say this makes sense. All this stuff makes definitely a lot of sense. And if we look at my notes here, what do I have here? Take one capsule twice daily. It makes a big difference which one is taken. Could be taken with or without food. Better to buy the probiotic on iHerb since it's refrigerated. I recommend this probiotic, B. longum. You could also buy it on Amazon as well. So BB536 is definitely my favorite one, and that's the most studied one. You want to take 10 billion at least twice a day. The more you take, the better of the effect it has. You could see B. longum, BB536. These are specific studies done on this one. But this one, I definitely recommend, absolutely recommend the BB536. And I think it's crucial. It's one of the, you know, most important probiotics in my regimen. So let's go through my notes on this. There's different kinds of B. longums, BB536. It's in a bunch of different brands. Resistant to high acid environment. Prebiotics are GOS, inulin, FOS. I take all of these, by the way. It's used for, these are my notes of particularly what I'm interested in. Gas, balances the gut bacteria, reduces the production of both methane and hydrogen sulfide. So this, not only does it help with the gas, it helps with smelly gas. If you eat a lot of protein, what happens is sometimes you don't have enough of certain microbes. It turns in, the bacteria consume certain amino acids and they turn them into methane and hydrogen sulfide. That's why your gas can smell like sulfur. If you eat, let's say, a lot of eggs or something like that, because it has a lot of cysteine there and a lot of methionine. So something like D. longum not only helps reduce the gas, it helps reduce the smelliness of gas. And that's something I've noticed. Gut constipation. So it helps the constipation, anti-gas, increases TPH1. So this is tryptophan hydroxylase 1, meaning it helps increase serotonin. Increases tryptophan in the blood, presumably by decreasing IDO. So serum tryptophan is actually important for longevity and certain other benefits, meaning you get more tryptophan that you could use in your brain for serotonin. Butyrate, this is one of them that increases butyrate, which is quite important. It, more specifically, probiotics with high biliary salt hydrolase activity, B. longum, may decrease total cholesterol and LDL cholesterol by lowering intestinal cholesterol reabsorption. suppressed phosphorus, we went through that, suppressed interferon gamma. If you're TH1 dominant, this is going to be relevant. Produces longicin. This is an antimicrobial peptide. So decreases trichinellin, which is associated with mortality, promotes IPA production that helps with, it's one of the tryptophan metabolites important for tolerance. Reduces TMA, reducing bacteria, reduces urea plasma. That's a, you know, STD, if you will. Bile acid metabolism. I think I have some issues or had some issues with bile acid metabolism, aids in protein digestion. So these are all things that are interesting for me. Isolated from human feces, sourced from human gut. So this is something that's natively gut. Very effective against GI discomfort. Long-term, when I took it in day and night, GI effects from sulfur went away. So meaning when consuming a lot of sulfur, I didn't get any smell of gas. Took 5 capsules when I was having some GI issues, seemed to improve them. Felt a bit weird, but could be from anything. Next day, GI issues seemed to be gone. 6 capsules, the morning shake. So it seemed like the more I took of this, the better I did. Took 1 gram. So I also took a D-Longum powder, and that seems to have helped as well. So it seems like different ones help, but definitely my favorite is the BB536. So there we have it. B-Longum is one of my favorite probiotics, if not my favorite. And I've done many megadosing experiments with it to good results. You could take as much as you want, pretty much. And I notice better results the more I take. So, but in general, I take 10 billion morning, night, and I take a lot of other probiotics. So I'm taking 200 supplements a day. And that is not something you want to learn from me about. But with this kind of, with these podcasts, you can see why I'm taking each one. And you could see, hey, look, maybe this guy's not as crazy as I would have thought. Because people who say, oh, wow, you're taking so many supplements. Well, I have very good reasons why I take each one. I'm really trying to optimize every biomarker, trying to have every improvement that I can. And, you know, I don't need to take 200. I could take less. But I just happen to take a lot because I'm doing different experiments all the time and trying different things, trying to optimize. So there you have it. Let me know what your thoughts are. Please like and subscribe. Let me know if you want me to do more of these podcasts and to go over the, you know, my experiments with things, the benefits of things. And yeah, thank you for listening and to BetterHelp.
67% of listeners aren't subscribed to the show, so please don't forget to show your support by hitting the subscribe button now. You'll not only be supporting the show, but also investing in yourself and your health journey, all while helping to keep us ad-free.